Yo, hey, what up, Stream?
What's up with you, man? What's going on, man?
Yo, what up, man?
What's up, they're good?
Hey, man, what up? Yo, your boy for life, man.
Yeah.
We here in Bed-Stuy at the park, chilling, man, hanging out with Q Crew.
Hanging out.
Q Casa, you know what I mean?
Okay. So what's up, man?
Not much, man. Just working on new records, working on an album now, man. I dropped a mixtape.
Okay.
That was last year, man, last December. So, it's been a minute. Just dropped this new music video, Lonely People. Came out about 2 weeks ago. Check that out on YouTube, Your Boy for Life, Lonely People.
Okay.
And they all make cameos in it, man. But now just working on the album, man. Working hard.
So you got your crew with you now? Who's with you?
My name's Professor Business.
Okay, Business. Business. What's up with you?
It's Scotty Bugatti.
Okay, Scotty Bugatti. It's like a car, man. Got the new Scotty Bugatti.
Soon have that car.
Yeah, soon to be,
okay,
man.
Okay.
Yeah.
So look, man, first question I want to ask you, man. Working on What's Really Hood DVD, you want to say that? What'sreallyhood.com, the web will never be the same. You know, we're trying to take it over. We've been doing it for like 6-7 years right now, trying to get it in. And actually, I saw you, to be truthful, I saw you actually yesterday by looking at another video on YouTube. I looked up to the right where they had other videos that was related to it, and I hit you up. And everybody watching right now, dude hit me back within an hour later. And now it's the next day, we're right here together doing the interview.
That's right, man.
So look, man, how long you been doing your thing?
Man, writing? Probably been writing for about like 12 to 14 years, but really grinding with the rap music, man. I mean, like, you know, putting out music, you know, playing shows, probably like 4 years. You know what I mean? 4 years been doing that, you know? So, 4 years really tough. I mean, the past 2 years, we've been really pushing it full force with freestyle videos, you know, music videos, and just, you know, all the bullshit, man. You know what I mean?
I said, who inspired you? I mean, what made you stop? Because, you know what I'm saying? There's no disrespect or whatever, but, you know, people watching talking about, oh, it's a white dude, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're going to say that.
Right.
You know what I mean? But, I mean, who inspired? What made you do what you do? You know what I mean?
I mean, I've always been a hip-hop head.
Okay.
You know, I mean, I've always listened to rock music. Definitely a good background.
Okay.
Good backbone. But I grew up listening to, man, from Wu-Tang, you know, Cannabis.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Big L.
Okay.
You know, Tribe Called Quest. I mean, you know, M. Definitely. So a whole variety, you know, of artists, man, from flow to lyrics. You know, I touch on the underground, you know, Rakim, Kool G Rap, big influences on me. And they help mold my style, you know what I mean? So, you know, basically what you listen to is what you kind of in the end
describe. Yeah, because I was watching yesterday. I showed a co-worker of mine, man. He's like, yo, dude is nice, man. We watched one you did a 6'7" video in the back seat.
Yeah, you were just going in.
So.
Yeah, man.
It seems to me that like I picked this up. When he just starts spitting and y'all just catch it, man.
That's how it goes. Yeah, but we'll just be driving around and they're just like, yo, man, just, you know, driving for like long road trips, going to a show or something like that.
Yeah, they're
like, hey, man, you know, you'll spit a freestyle. I'm always in the back seat though.
Yeah, I'm always in the back seat.
That's how we figured probably. Yeah, maybe I should do my whole entire album in the back seat.
Yeah, right? That's what it is. Like, yeah. Call the first album back seat.
Yeah, but they just throw on the beat and I just start freestyling with it.
I'm serious. Take your album picture in the back seat.
They call that shit back seat.
So the back seat driver be back seat rapper. You know what I mean, like that.
Yeah, man, look up on your boy for life. Back seat mixtape, man. Maybe after the album.
That's what that was. So look, so all the people inspired you, man. Do your thing. So, like the first time you started doing it, like what was your trial? Like what, you know, what happened? Your friends was there. Or they didn't believe you want to do it or what? Or what happened? You know what I mean?
Back in high school, freestyle battling.
Oh, y'all was battling in high school?
I battled even Joe Budden, man. This is my sophomore year, because I really started battling in junior high school. And I wasn't really that, you know, I wasn't really type dope. I was just getting up there, man. But in high school, I really started writing. And I'm basically a backpack freestyle rapper. In my earlier years, I was actually out in Flatbush sophomore year. This is probably like 2002. I must have been like 16 years old, and there was a freestyle contest kind of on the corner, and I actually battled Budden. This is when his Pump It Up video came out. Man.
Oh, yeah, you don't like that, bro.
That was big, you know, so I kind of try. I tweet him sometimes, man, try to get his attention. He ignores me, man.
Okay.
He ignores me, but, like, you know, big ups to Budden and the whole Slaughterhouse team.
Well, you know what? He might see this, man, because them guys kind of watch what I do, man.
No, man, they're big, man. They're making big moves, man. Shout outs.
Yeah. Actually, I can see you in that group with them, too, the way you're doing your thing. But it's come a long way.
Four-headed monsters, man.
Okay. So look, what? Like I said, when you first started, man, you know what I mean? You know, you said battles in school and everything. So you started doing mixtapes. But how did they go when you first sell them at school?
I used to put them. I mean, I I sold a few of them, but mainly what I would do was just save up money. I used to work back in Ecuador, like a pharmacy. I used to work in a photo lab. I used to work, save up money, and just buy a bunch of blank CDs and just throw a bunch of songs that I record on the CD and just hand them out.
Okay.
Just hand them out like that. Go, you know, get them to sell, but hand them out. Like, all right, guys, go free of charge. Just take it. You know, just listen. I just want you to listen to it. That's
okay,
it.
Okay.
You know, just to get my word out.
And listen to my demo. Yeah, yeah.
First few years, I mean, hard. I mean, still hard. The grind is hard.
Okay, okay.
But our grind is inevitable, man. We keep pushing, so.
So this is your crew, this is your everyday crew? You say you got
more
guys?
Yeah, we got more heads. I mean, okay. You know, shout out to my boy Matty Ice, Paulie Gags, everybody back home. But yeah, we usually hang out together, man. You know, just spit bars.
Okay.
You know, like, have fun. Chill.
All right. So you born and raised in New York?
Born and raised in Queens, New York.
Okay, that's what that was. That's
all I know.
All right. So look, you got anything new you working on right now?
Yeah. I'm actually working with this producer, GQ. Shout out to GQ and Stoffister. He's working on my album. Like I said, I just dropped Lonely People. We're coming out with a Q Crew song.
Okay.
Probably gonna come up with a video for it in about a month and a half tops. So we're trying to wrap that up, but just basically new music, trying to put out more freestyles too, because I know people like the freestyles, so.
Yeah.
I on my YouTube, I just ask people what instrumentals you want me to spit on, and they just kind of give me instrumentals, and I just go, you know, I go with the flow.
Okay. So you got requests?
Yeah, I take requests now, man.
Okay. So your fan base building up on YouTube, which is very smart.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The internet is the way to go right now. You know, do your thing on that. All right, so what else you got coming on? Who make your beats for you that you rap to?
GQ. GQ makes a few beats, but I'm looking pretty much for producers right now.
Okay.
I'm about two songs under my album. I need about four or five more. So,
okay.
Producers, if you hear this, you know, get at me. Okay. I need beats.
All right,
I'd love to work with y'all.
Okay.
Yeah, man, that's right, yo. Your boy for life. Lonely People.
Check it out,
man.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm talking
to Mr. Smith. What team?
Huh?
Mr. Smith.
Mr. Smith?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No problem.
So I just want to let you know you've been a great asset to this company, but we've been downsizing a lot, and we're going to have to let you go, unfortunately.
You mean just like let me, because of downsizing?
Yeah, we can't keep the salary on board.
Okay. Okay.
Sinking underground and drowning as long as I'm earthbound. And in the middle, a little fizzle, I'm fist pounding. But the door won't open up. Tired of sitting and hoping I'm flipping some dope in and mixing the cocaine jam. Smoking like a chimney, killing me. I'm living the moment when I
look at all
and realize I'm not the only one. When I
look at all
trying to walk through my head high, but I coincide with the vital we got, so I
look at all the
gotta pick a side. man, I'm one of them. Blood are running in 10,000 times more haters, from 100 men to 1,000,000. Pardon me, I ain't feeling him. You a hater, Darth Vader, you into oblivion. Sucker ass reptilian, catch our beat down willingly. So bad when you get home, you still feeling me. A rebounding off a missed opportunity. Film walls like the first stage of puberty. Ain't shit new to me, it's Saturday night. I'm dressed up with nowhere to go, looking like an asshole. I could pour my whole entire heart out, but it'd be easier for you to rip your parts out. I'm drinking and driving, about to flip the car out. Where you are now, no one will notice you far down. I dream a lot, and when I apply to reality, it turns into a nightmare and a tragedy. You realize I'm not the only one when I'm trying to walk with my head high, but we coincide with the vibe of the guy, so you take what you want, keep what you got, never gon' stop, no way. Never drop to the bottom of the rocks, never gon' plop. Better get a daytime job and quit the app and stand back and watch the incredible rhyme shredder. Nobody do it better, and he lonely as ever, but never would he ever underestimate whether or not he got what it take to overcome the pressure. Ha! Shoulda got a lock for the drama. I'm a prop like a kettle top on the stove, terror. Me alone is suicide, leaving me is homicide. In the end, everybody die alone. Otherwise, a progressive worldwide genocide. So why we choose to live alone for the rest of our lives? I don't get it, they don't wanna give me credit. Fuck it, you don't gotta make it public, shove it and give me the merit. Oh well, gotta make it out the cold spell, or live alone to find my body in a motel. Realize I'm not the only one when I'm trying to walk with my head high, but we coincide with the vibe of the guy, so what's it gonna take? Something's gotta give.
Y'all enjoy the video, Lonely People, man. Directed by my man, Caesar McKay. Produced by GQ. Shout out to the crew, man.
Okay.
Send me some feedback. Let me know if you guys like it, man. YouTube, your boy for life.
Alright, so look, man. When you do get into industry, are you going to, well, it's hard to say, not industry or whatever. I know you're going to do independent first, because that's your grind. But who would you like to work with when you get into industry, or before you get into industry? Who would you like to work with?
Who would I like to work with?
Yeah, yeah. You already said button, so I mean, who else you want to get in? You know, who you want to get it in with?
I mean, there's a lot. I mean, for up and coming artists, man, definitely yeah. J. Cole.
Okay.
J. Cole's doing his thing. I really respect his work, man, and you know, it's dope, man. It's a new breath, a new fresh in hip hop, man. And J. Cole. Sure, man. I always, man, had a knack for just wanting to work with the Dipset dudes.
Okay.
Joel Santana, you know, shout out to Jim Jones, Killer Cam, man.
Yeah.
The whole crew. Definitely Cannabis. I mentioned him earlier, man. I've been trying to work with him. I know the dude's busy, man, with his whole lyrical law, Rip the Jacket to Infinity work, man. But shout out to the bass. I want to get definitely a track in with him, man. It's been a dream of mine, you know, but a variety of artists, man. It's just, like, definitely artists that help mold me who I am today. You know, Wu-Tang, I'd love to get on a track with all of them, but you know, rappers like Raekwon, Ghostface, you know, the album 36 Chambers, man, it was just,
yeah,
that was my jump off, man, that was the shit, so
okay.
Definitely them too, man.
Okay, so what do you say is your style? Is it you rap fast, or are you a twister kind of rapper, or you slow rap, or you mix them up, or what do you do?
I mix it up a little bit, man. I start off being very heavy lyrical,
yeah.
Started working on the flow, so, I like dope flows. I like, the root of it is still underground lyrical hip hop,
okay.
Regardless, you know, but I speed it up a lot, you know, I slow it down. I like to kind of be choppy. I like to kind of be innovative, you know, to kind of keep the, you know, the listeners, you know, attentive, keep them listening. Cause you know, sometimes one flow kind of bores you out. So I just try to switch it up a little bit, make it a little exciting. Try to have a storyline in there too. Just mix it up, different concepts, you know, I'm working with, so.
Yeah.
I just hope, you know, everyone enjoys the product, man. It's hard work.